I want you to be my chef at the B&B.
Chef?
Maybe you could make up a menu for tonight's party and we could just see.
He is not happy. I just quit.
David, I can't hire you yet.
I know, but I'm miserable waiting tables. I'm too excited to get started.
Okay, not that this is freaking me out, but why is it on steroids?
Because you're beautiful.
I just don't like talking about myself.
Why? What's the big deal? I talk about myself. I'm an open book.
Sometimes a little confusing to read.
Jess?
Yes?
I have the citizenship.
You can say it. I won't stop you.
You're chicken. Gonna love it.
I decided the kiss did not happen.
What?
Because I will mess this up. And you are my friend, and I don't want to lose that.
I'm pretty sure this guy you mentioned feels the same way about you.
We don't need to talk, because needing to talk implies bad news.
Jess, I'm leaving.
You're leaving me? Lord,
I'm not breaking up with you. I'm breaking up with the inn.
He also gave the house for $10,000 when I accidentally bought 1,000 books.
You what?
That's crazy.
Whoa. My sister's crazy.
Why didn't you say anything?
If you wanted me to know, you would have told me.
You get me so well.
You're fired.
I don't get you off. All I want is to get to know you.
Okay. My father is Dennis Lyle Peck.
You're a Boston Peck?
Why didn't you tell me who you were? It wouldn't have changed anything. I still would have hired you as my cook. I just wouldn't have felt so bad about not paying you.
I didn't want it to change anything between us. I wanted you to see me for me.
My mother's a Boston Peck. I mean, don't say goodbye to me, okay?
Okay.
David, you are the new CEO of Peck Enterprises.
Whoa.
Down here!
What are you doing?
I wanted to talk to you privately. I just need to tell you that if you want to stay here because you're really good at your job, I will be okay. But if you want to come back with me, that'll be fine too.
Just fine?
Fine as in amazing. But it's your choice.
Jess, ever since I became your chef, I only want to be with you.
No right to spy on me. This is just not cool and mean and rotten and wrong.
The world isn't ours, but I know.
Jess, O'Brien,
David,
I think you forgot something.
Like it's all I have. I know it'll kill me when it's over. I don't want to think about it.
Would you like to go on a date with me? I don't know. To a restaurant?
Like a real date?
So I'm going to love you now. Like it's all I have. I know it'll kill me when it's over. I don't want to think about it. I want you to love me now.
Jess, wait. Let me help.
I got it. I'm fine.
You're not fine. Here, can we talk about this at least?
Why? I had plans. Not just for the inn, but for us in the inn.
Something inside us knows there's nothing guaranteed.
I love you. Tell me that you never leave. I love you. David. When we've done all that we could to turn darkness into light, turn evil to good, even when we try so hard for that perfect kind of love, it could
no matter what, we'll get through it together. Like peanut butter and jam.
Oh, I'm gonna love like you now. Pinot Noir. And
I know we are so meant to be.
I know. I don't want to think about it. I want you to love me now. Love me now. Love me now. Oh, love me now. Scissors. Oh, here. I'll be right back.
Jess, I have a question.
It's all right. Yes, David Peck. You can ask.
Right. Should we leave room for tulips or begonias?
I don't know who's gonna kiss you when I'm gone. So I'm gonna love you now. Like it's all I have. I know it'll kill me when it's over. I don't wanna think about it. I want you to love me now. I don't know who's gonna kiss you when I'm
gone. Yes, O'Brien. So I'm gonna love you now. Like it's all there is nobody else like you. In kill me when it's over. I don't wanna think about it. I would love nothing more than to spend the rest of my life giving you your happy. I know I want to be with you.
Do you take Jess to be your wife?
I do.
Do you take David to be your husband?
I do.
It's fun.
You should have seen it coming. That my trust fund has been cleaned out. The other person that has access to that, obviously, is my father.
He left the country. No, he fled.
You are not alone in this. Remember that. I'm here.
My dad called.
What?
Thanks for making me feel less crazy.
Usually it's you doing that for me, so I can return the favor.
That's what a marriage is, isn't it? Just making each other feel less crazy.
Have you ever told your father how you feel?
No. Why? What would be the point? It's not like he's gonna change.
It's not for his sake, it's for yours.
I think he really was framed.
My husband is the type of man who would never let an innocent person go to jail if he had any way to help them. No matter who that person was.
Why did you get so wise?
I woke up like this. Get nice from something we're good at.
You're good at things.
Name one.
Kissing.
What if we go out of business?
Jess O'Brien, you are the most capable person I have ever met. And the B&B is not going out of business because it's yours. And if there's one thing I know about you, it's that you know how to make things work.
No, no, no. That stays outside.
See? I don't know who to reach out to anymore. I called all the attorneys on the list that Connor gave me, and nobody wants to take my father's case.
We will find someone.
It's not just you. Together, we can do anything. I care about you and care about us. And you're closing yourself off.
Sorry.
Don't be sorry. Just don't get so caught up in worry that you think that you're alone, because you're not.
Thanks.
That's right. I know life has been rough, but you can't forget about the most important person in your life.
I know, myself.
No, me. Me.
Oh, right. How could I forget? We could take a boat out to one of the islands.
Wonderful.
I'll make a picnic.
No cooking. You just relax. I'll go to Sally's and pick something up. You get the boat ready.
Okay. This is gonna be wonderful. You know, when I found out that my dad stole my trust fund, I felt so betrayed.
I know.
It was scary as hell, but I was independent. Just you and me against the world.
Yep.
Your hair looks really pretty.
Oh, yeah. I washed it.
For me?
Mm-hmm. I like those little green flecks in your eyes.
Thank you.
I really think we can win this thing.
This is the first ray of hope I've had in months, so thank you guys.
What was that for?
That is for you being you. These last few months have been so hard, and I would not have been able to get through it without you. No, I mean it. First time in ages, it feels like it's gonna be better instead of worse.
Not the same way. And I've been thinking.
Thinking what?
About your being a father, and me being a mother, and us being parents.
You have?
I have.
Okay.
And the idea used to scare me, because I didn't think I would be a good mom. But now...
But now?
I think I'd like to try. Would you?
I would.
Okay.
Okay. Wow. Okay. You sure about this, Jess?
Sure.
Okay. Once all this gets figured out with my dad, we can start...
Or we could do it sooner.
Like, now?
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
All right, let's go!
Wait. We kind of already started.
What?
I took a few tests.
A few?
8. They're all positive.
I'm gonna be a dad?
Yeah.
You're gonna be a mom?
When I was at the ceremony, all I could think about was how things come back to where they belong. To where they're meant to be. To mom and dad.
You're here. Mm-hmm.
To mom and dad.
Mom and dad. Oh, honey. Oh, and I'm pregnant!
What?
Oh!